Welcome back. Joining me tonight exclusively on India Decides is the former Chief Justice of India, Justice J.S. Varma, who the Prime Minister has also asked to use his good offices with Anna Hazare to call off his fast. Justice Varma, thank you for joining me tonight, sir. You have issued an appeal now to Anna Hazare and his team, and you've used quite strong words. Welcome. You haven't minced your words, as you never do. Could you tell us, Justice Varma, what you want to say to Anna Hazare today?
Well, I'll read out. You see, as a concerned citizen in national interest, I have been closely observing the developments relating to the fast undertaken by Anna Hazare, which has now reached at a critical stage. The Prime Minister's statement made in the Lok Sabha today, assuring discussion of the Jan Lokpal Bill prepared by the Anna team, along with all versions of the Lokpal Bill prepared by Aruna Roy, Jayaprakash Narayan and any other section of the civil society,
yes,
ending with his appeal to Anna Hazare to end his fast, was adopted unanimously by the House at the behest of the Lok Sabha Speaker. This is a very positive development whereby all political parties cutting across party lines, led by the leader of opposition, unanimously adopted this resolution,
yes,
and urged Anna Hazare to end his fast forthwith. In my view, there is no justification, at least now, for the continuance of the fast undertaken by Anna Hazare, and I appeal to him to end his fast forthwith in keeping with the national sentiment and concern for his health. I would advise the members of his team to persuade him to do so without any delay. I am sure the concern of all the members of his team would be the same, which has already been indicated by Justice Santosh Hegde, making such an appeal even earlier.
Yes.
They being closest to him are in a position to prevail upon him to end his fast. I am afraid continuation of the present impasse with Anna Hazare's fast may not appear reasonable and may even appear to be a disrespect for the national sentiment as well as for the democratic polity, including that of the parliament and the constitution. I do hope that situation does not arise, and to prevent that is the primary responsibility of the members of the Anna Hazare team who have been continuously advising him.
I therefore join
the nation,
yes,
in appealing to Anna Hazare to end his fast forthwith so that he is available for the national service for many more years to come.
Justice
in my view, this is the call of the nation, required to be honored by Anna Hazare,
yes,
and his entire team.
Justice Varma, you made that, yes, point in very strong words. You've used the words unreasonable. You've said that now it would be a disrespect of the parliament, of the national sentiment. Why do you feel that so strongly? You've observed what's been going on over the last 10 days. Are you worried about certain aspects which are being overlooked? What to you is the key issue which faces the nation today?
Well, personally, I'm of the view that it is in such a situation, if you look to the past events, it is only for the purpose of learning, but certainly not for continuing the differences.
Mm-hmm.
This is the stage. Anna Hazare's life is of great significance to the entire nation. He has made the point, vulcanized, you see, they mobilized all the support in the crusade against corruption,
yes,
and made the political parties the entire to commit to work for combating corruption. Now the modalities will take time and experts have to decide. Anna Hazare ji certainly has made this yeoman contribution, and I think now is the time for him to see that the people who are required to perform this task get busy doing that task and not only trying to persuade him to end his fast. Because most of,
yes,
the time is being spent by everyone at present only to persuade him to end his fast.
NDTV's cricket app, Android and iPhone, fastest scorecard, special analysis and much more. Download free, ndtv.com/apps.